established, it will stand forever. But I want you to understand that Rome had to be around at the coming of the Lord. I just want you to understand that first. Now, let's go to Matthew chapter 24. Matthew chapter 24, and this is dealing with the coming of the Lord. Matthew chapter 24, and we begin reading at verse 3. Matthew 24 and 3. 24 and 3. This is dealing with the coming of the Lord. That's what Daniel 2nd chapter was dealing with, and that is what Matthew is dealing with here. Start reading at verse 3. Go ahead and read.
And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying,
go ahead.
Tell us, when shall these things be, and what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?
You know, first he was telling them, they were telling him, rather, about that temple that was standing there in Jerusalem. And Jesus said, you see this temple? There shall not be one stone left upon another that shall not be thrown down. And so, and Jesus said, tell us, when shall these things be? And what will be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world? When will the temple be destroyed? First of all, he didn't bother to address that. Then they said, and what will be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world? And he did address that. Go ahead and read on.
And Jesus answered and said unto them,
Take
heed that no man deceive you.
Go ahead.
For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many.
Now, first thing he's telling you is don't be deceived about this whole thing here, because there would be people coming in his name, acknowledging that he is Christ, but yet they would deceive many. Go ahead and read on.
And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars.
And there will be wars and rumors of wars, just like we're looking at today. Go ahead and read on.
See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet.
Read on.
For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places.
Just like we're looking at today. Go ahead and read that next verse.
All these are the beginning of sorrow.
Now, all of these are the beginning of sorrow. Now, skip down to verse 15 and continue to read.
When ye therefore shall see the abomination of desolation, spoken of by Daniel the prophet, stand in a holy place, whosoever readeth, let him understand.
Now, he said, when you see the abomination of desolation, and he said it was even spoken of by Daniel the prophet, and when you see it stand in the holy place, then he said, whosoever readeth, let him understand. You need to understand what this is. This is one of the signs of his coming. And if you do not understand what this is, then you don't know what to watch for. Now, he said, when you see it standing in the holy place, then this is what you ought to do. Go ahead and read.
Then let them which be in Judea flee into the mountains.
Wait a minute. Suppose you don't understand what this is. You'll be looking right at it and you ain't going to move.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But he's telling you, when you see it, then let them that be in Judea flee into the mountain. But I'm going to tell you, if you are not in Judea, you ought to flee to those same mountains. Notice he didn't say, wait on no rapture.
Yes, sir.
He said, flee into the mountain. There's something that you ought to do. That is why you need to understand the sign, because when certain things happen, there are things that you are supposed to do. Go ahead. Well, let's skip down to verse 21. I'm going to show you, when this abomination of desolation stand in the holy place, what's going to happen? Go ahead and read.
For then shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, no, nor ever shall be.
So that's why you need to know what that is, because then will be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world, neither will it ever be again. Let's go now to 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. Again, we're going to deal with the coming of the Lord here. And we are going to pick up this abomination of desolation. However, Paul wrote to the Thessalonians, and he did not call it abomination of desolation. He called it something else. Let's pick it up at 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. And we'll begin reading at verse 1. 2 and 1. 2 and 1. Now, Paul going to give you the same warning that Jesus gave you. Make certain that you don't be deceived. Because the Lord understood about all the deception that would be going on during this time. And he understood as well, it is most important that you do not be deceived. Because your salvation might be at stake if you don't get it right. Let's start reading here at 2 Thessalonians 2 and begin at verse 1. 2 Thessalonians 2 and 1. Go ahead and read.
Now, we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by our gathering together unto him.
Now, what are we dealing with here? The coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, right? What are we dealing with in Daniel 2? The coming of the Lord, yeah. Right? What was we dealing with in Matthew 24? The coming of the Lord, right? Mm-hmm. You know, we're going to get all the details here today. Yes, you know, sometimes we kind of skim over stuff. We're going to deal with it in an intricate way a little bit. Go ahead and read on.
That ye be not soon shaken in mind.
Now he said, I don't want you to be shaken in mind. Go ahead and read.
Neither troubled.
Uh-huh.
Neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter as from us, as that day of Christ is at hand.
Now he's telling the people here, I don't want you to be troubled by anything, as that day of Christ is at hand, because he's going to tell them that there's something that must happen before that day can come. You know, Jesus gave you the whole outline of it. And he said, when you see all these things happening, then know it's coming as near, even at the door. Paul's going to deal with one thing in particular here, and he's going to tell you. Go ahead and read.
3. Let no man deceive you by any means.
Go ahead.
For that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition.
Now, this is the abomination of desolation here. Paul calling the man of sin the son of perdition. You know what perdition is? Destruction. So now the man of sin, the son of perdition. Go ahead and read on.
Who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God.
Now this is what he's going to do. You know, Jesus said the abomination of desolation standing in the holy place, right? Well, Paul's going to tell you, you know, the holy place is none other than the temple. And we understand the temple will be built in Jerusalem. And all of the time they're talking about it. It's just a matter of time before it's going to happen. It's going to happen. Make no mistake about that. Because the Lord is telling you these things must happen before the Lord can come. If the man going to sit in the temple, then a temple got to be built, right?
Yes, sir.
He can't sit in one if it's not built, right?
Yes, sir.
So one must be built. Now he said, who opposes and exalteth himself above all that is called God. Go ahead and read on.
Or that is worshipped.
Go ahead
so
and read.
That he is God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God.
Now this is truly an abomination. Some man going to oppose and exalt himself above all that is called God. That means even the Father.
Mm-hmm.
He going to exalt himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped. So that he as God going to sit in the temple of God, declaring himself to be God. Go ahead and read on.
5. Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things.
Uh-huh.
And know ye not, and now ye know what withholdeth that he might be revealed in his time.
Go ahead and read.
For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who know letteth will let until he be taken out of the way.
Go ahead and read.
And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming.
So if the Lord going to destroy him with the brightness of his coming, that means he's going to be around at the coming of the Lord,
yes,
right?
Sir.
Go ahead and read that next verse.
9.
Uh-huh.
Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan.
Oh, this is Satan's man here. You understand what I'm saying? Even I'm going to put this up here. I'm going to just stick Satan over here. He said, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan. Go ahead and read.
With all power and signs and lying wonders.
And with all power and signs and lying wonders. What's the stuff he will be doing? You know, he's going to be doing signs and lying wonders. Let's go now to and pick him up at Daniel chapter 11. And we're going to begin reading at verse 36. Daniel 11, and we're going to pick him up at verse 36. 11 and 36. Because Jesus told you he was spoken of by Daniel the prophet, didn't he? Now, Daniel chapter 11, we're going to pick him up at verse 36. 11 and 36. Paul said he's going to oppose and exalt himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped. So that he as God will sit in the temple of God, declaring himself to be God. This is going to happen, people. You know, mm-hmm. this ain't something we just reading about here. This is going to actually happen before the Lord can come. Let's go to Daniel chapter 11, and we'll pick it up at verse 36. And now we're going to find out where that temple will be that he is going to sit in. Start reading at verse 36. Go ahead and read.
And the king shall do according to his will.
Uh-huh.
And he shall exalt himself and magnify himself above every god.
Wait a minute. Now, the same thing Paul wrote, isn't it? That's where you think he got it from. What, you think he made it up?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we say it all of the time.